What a 2021 it was for Raquel. It was a bad one. Don't forget. As I was saying, don't forget WrestleMania week last year when Stand and Deliver, Raquel defeated Io Shirai for the NXT Women's Championship. What a come-out year that was.
And the topic of NXT Stand and Deliver will be part of the most stupendous WrestleMania week ever in Dallas. But right now, oh, getting planted is Jade into another cover. Could this be it? Jade again.
The risk is all on Raquel Gonzalez, and I fully understand why she would be so hesitant to team up with someone so young, so inexperienced.
Whoa!
I mean, she's keeping on swinging. Hats off to her.
Poor Jade continuing to battle, and once again gets caught. And once again gets submission! Poor Jade trying to get full extension of the right arm on Raquel Gonzalez. NXT Universe trying to will on Cora Jade. But once again, Jade trying to hold on. And it's Raquel Gonzalez overpowering Jade.
Gonzalez in agony as Cora Jade tries to pull off the impossible.
High risk, high reward. Jade has Gonzalez down. This is Cora Jade's best opportunity.
That's where you've got to make it count. You've got Big Mammy Cool rocking and rolling right now. Can she put this one to bed?
Jade has been riding the wave of momentum for months. Can she continue to ride it for one more night? And up, and Gonzalez, she's gonna bomb!
One, two, three,
Gonzalez puts an end to Jade.
Here is your winner, Raquel Gonzalez!
I mean, Wade, I know what you said throughout the match, but even you have to look at Cora Jade and admire the effort Jade gave us here tonight.
Hats off to Cora Jade. I picked the winner from the beginning. I did not expect Raquel Gonzalez to have to hit top gear in this matchup. She did, and at times, she was lucky to survive what Cora Jade was throwing at.
Gonzalez saying, let's go and win this?
Look at that, doesn't he care?